point is, we sing His glory. That's why all of you look energetic, quite young. What is the secret to be young? How to look young? There are many people with crores and crores of money. There are people with a lot of gold kept in the chest. Wonderful mansions, furniture, with a castroil face. With a castroil face, quite unfriendly, no smile in their lifetime. What do you do with that cash? It is trash and ash in my sight if you cannot enjoy the life. The life has to be enjoyed. The life has to be lived, not to be led. Let us live our life, not lead our lives. Usually Sundays, staff, doctors and paramedical staff would like to stay back at home, make puddings for the children for the coming next week, or at least engage themselves with washing machine at least, or mop the floor, vacuum cleaner. But yet you could make yourself free and available and spare your time is the proof of the living divinity of Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. You could spare your time. You could come here to express your gratitude to Swami is the secret of your smiles. You are so healthy. You are so good looking. You do not know. You do not know. You are so handsome and beautiful too. Why? How do I say that? If you compare yourself with a person of the same age, supposing if you are 70, compare yourself with a person of 70 of your age elsewhere. Arthritis, pneumonitis, bronchitis, spondylitis, whatnot. They forget to go around the temples, they circumambulate around hospitals. What do they talk about? What is your MG? 25 MG or 50 MG? What is my MG? Who is your doctor? Who is my doctor? How far your daughter-in-law kicking you? How nicely my daughter-in-law is kicking me? This is the horrible talk. But Sai devotees of our age, children should seek an appointment to see us. Yes? I often tell my children, take it from me. I will never stay with you. No, I may just may visit you, that's all. And you may have to sometimes see me sitting among the audience abroad. I don't stay. Why? Because to live in hope that children will take care of you is a hopeless thought these days now. Children are not going to take care of you. There's only one caretaker. Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. That's why people are happy. Let us rely on Him. Let us depend upon Him. We don't need anybody to take care of us. How are you? Excellent. How are you? Cannot be better than this. How are you? I'm doing well for this age. That should be our answer, which is a fact. Therefore, my friends, if all Sai devotees are good looking, quite hale and healthy, are still happy in the midst of problems. We do have problems. Yes? Some problems have no solution. We have problems. But yet, the problem will never be a problem to us. Because we laugh at a problem, because the solution to the problem is at the lotus feet of Bhagavan. It is His job to solve your problems. When you carry loads and loads of heavy weight, keep it in the compartment in your train journey, you will not headache. You will not get headache, no. Your shoulders will never pain, no. Why? The compartment train carries the luggage. Luggage belongs to you, but the train carries the luggage. Bhagavan, such as an intercontinental airline, carries the luggage and the baggage of our families. So why should you worry? We have no worry. Baggage of problems are there. but he will take care of it. That's why Sai devotees smile and smile, relaxed in spite of, in the midst of all problems. But what I can say, my friends, since it's a closed meeting, you will allow me if I make a statement, and don't misunderstand. Sai institutions are general and universal. Hospital meeting is not for hospital staff only. A meeting of the anniversary of the hospital of this type of hospital requires a celebration at a higher level, in a grand scale. In fact, it should have been celebrated there in Sai Ramesh Hall and not here. Because hospital is not only the property of doctors and administrators. You are the custodians, you are the trustees, you are the sharp, powerful instruments. How about us? The whole city would have been happy to join us there in Sai Ramesh Hall to express our gratitude to Bhagavan for having given us such a beautiful hospital. Why? Because in a metropolis city like Bangalore, yes, medical care is unaffordable. Unaffordable. Right from those days, all these 35 years of long service, all villages owe their life to such a Sai General Hospital here in Whitefield. Owe their life, owe their health to this hospital. We know hundreds and hundreds lining up there. They would have been happy to share the joy of the occasion. That I share with you, taking a little bit step of liberty, about which I am sure you will never misunderstand. Because I have got 20 years of standing in the organization and 20 years standing here in the university. Therefore, my age, my long period of service demands frank expression, if not concealed ideas. Now, just few more points to just cheer you up, that's all. Because I find you rather still serious. No, we don't have to be serious. When Swami comes out of his bungalow, yema indra atlu naru, yema de, castor oil betukunare, castor oil face, why are you like that? We don't have to be serious, no. This is not emergency ward or a casualty. We can afford to smile, we can be happy, because Bhagavan is within us. He smiles, he makes you smile. Because you find people getting into the interview room, whosoever called, they go to long faces, as if they are carrying the weight of the whole planet Earth. By the time they return, they laugh and dance, jump and float. They are up in the air and not on the ground. Why? The presence of God is felt not by seriousness. Sickness is felt by seriousness. The God's presence is very much reflected by your smiles, by your laughter, by your humor, by your ecstasy, by your blissful state. That is a religion. Religion is not anything that is what you call imprisoning one's own self within a room. They bolt the doors and say, I'm meditating. Family members will be very happy. Please extend your meditation, because you are a nuisance if you are out of meditation. I'm sorry. To be happy, to smile and make others smile is the true meditation. To be tragic and making other lives equally tragic, in spite of your sadhana 24 hours, it is not a religious life at all. Therefore, smile and smile. Baba, what an assurance you said, Swami. These are the times, you know. Elderly people, what do they do at home? Then when they cross 70 or 80, what do? Immediately say, "Arey, I may leave the world anytime. Front room should belong to the first son. Second room to the next son. Broomstick to the first daughter. And tamarind to the youngest daughter." So first day, evening they'll be all right. Okay. Second day if they're sick again, they will change. No. First room to the daughter, not to them. They go and change their will. Because they're very much concerned about the property. When once they leave the world, what will happen to that? It's time that we think of Bhagavan's assurances. Swami, did you not say that? Did you not say that? Because you are the truth. Satya Sai Baba, you are the truth. Did you not say that? Yes, keep up to your promise. Further, what did you say, Bhagavan? You said, I'll keep up to my promise. I'll never give up. I'm as strong as a diamond. None can take me away from my decision. None can deviate, digress my concentration. I'll never give up my project, Swami, you said. And you also said, my property are the devotees. Bhagavan, we continue to be your property. We continue to be your valuable property. Bhagavan also said, Prashanti Nilayam. Please note this. These are the things collected from divine discourses, not my concoction or manipulation, imagination, much less hallucination. These are the divine's declarations, divine assurances, divine promises, which we often recall ourselves to strengthen our faith, to continue to live in faith, to continue to live in joy, to stop crying, to stop shedding tears. If we start crying, shed tears, it only means that we have taken him as a human being. No. Somebody said, because he is not a devotee, has Bhagavan left you? Somebody asked me, has Bhagavan dropped his body? My answer on phone was, he has not dropped the body because he was never the body. He has not left us because he is ever present with us. So Bhagavan says, Prashanti Nilayam is a paradise. Prashanti Nilayam is the very heaven on earth. From here I protect all of you. This is the statement of Bhagavan. Shirdi Praveshame Sarva Dukkha Pariharam. The solution to your misery is the very stepping into Sanctum Sanctorum there in Shirdi. Parthi is as much powerful as Shirdi. I protect everybody from this place. Prashantilayam, the generator. Swami, what a promise you made long back. You said, leave your burdens here, go back with joy. Swami, did you not say that you will wipe out all tears? Did you not say that you will make me smile? That a crying baby is fondled, caressed by the mother? You promised it, Swami. Yes, we rely on you. Swami, have you not said that you are there with open arms, inviting us if only we have faith and love in you? Let our doors of faith and love be open eternally for you to step into the mansion of our heart, beloved Swami. That should be that. Bhagavan, what did you say long back? I remember. You said, by the time you step into Prashantanalayam, when you come to hear the stories and experiences from other devotees, it is the living proof that I am blessing you. It is a living proof that I am with you. Because if you go to Chikpet or Bangalore railway station, nobody will speak about Baba. At the most, you may get some newspapers. The moment you get into Sai family, the moment you get into Sai fold, the moment you get step into Prashanthanilayam, nobody speaks of their property, nobody speaks of their bank account, nobody would come with a vain glory or self-glorification, glorification or vanity, nothing excepting Baba is the common link between devotees across the world, across the world. Therefore, whenever there is a talk about Swami, understand that I am blessing you. That's what Baba said. Another statement what he said was, in the early hours of the morning, as birds sing, cuckoo bird, nightingale, the cool breeze, the zephyr and aurora, the cool breeze in the morning, and the singing of the birds perched on the branches of trees reminds you of Prashanti Nilayam and Nagara Sankirtan. Prashanti Nilayam and Nagara Sankirtan, yes, you'll be reminded of that. Bhagavan said, I am with you, in you, above you, below you, around you, in you. If I forget one, he will supply the other one which I forgot in translation. And Swami said another point. I always think of it as he sits on the chair, sometimes one foot over the other foot, with the fingers moving like that, exact beat of the bhajans. As bhajans go on in full speed, Swami forgets himself, he is lost. I always tell my student friends in the faculty, if Swami starts reading letters as you are singing, understand it is boring. It's boring. If Swami gives padanamaskar to students that line up as you are speaking, you should understand it is time to keep your mouth shut. Because if it is interesting, he forgets himself. He is lost. The dancer is no longer there. The dance remains. Singer does not exist. The song remains. Painter is no more. The painting remains. So you are no more. You do not exist. Bhagavan exists. When you feel I am the singer, yes, he does not exist. Swami, I do not exist. I am not the singer. I am not anyone. Just as you said, I treat, he cures. So you are just there. I am nobody. That will give us that vibrations of the divine presence. So what does Baba say now? When you sing full throated, there are some people that sing as if they are grumbling, groaning with pain. No. When we shout at a neighbor, oh, we are at the climax. When we differ with the housewife, when she does not make a preparation of my choice, well, I'll have mona action of Viswamitra or Durvasa. But when it comes to bhajan, low voice, slow voice, indifferent, how do you enjoy that? When we sing bhajans, we should be lost. The beat, wow, it should take up, up and up. How about Bhagavan? How does he sing? How fast it is? And now Swami says this. If you sing full-throated, in full spirit, understand, I dance on the field of your hearts. So, as we are at work, let us sing. We need not sing loudly while at work. As you pass on from one room to another, from one corner to another, we can just sing that within ourselves to continue to be energetic. It is not the boost that gives you energy. It is not the calcium sandals that gives you energy. It is Sai Nama that gives energy and makes you energetic. Bhagavan said, to me, nothing is important other than my devotees. Nothing is important other than my devotees, said my Lord. And Swami said, if only you know my love, you will see it flow like the Ganges River. Like Ganges River, it is an eternal, continuous flow. My friends, I thought it necessary to recall all these assurances that he has given us in the past, which will stand by us. I have few words to share with you as a Sai mission. Today, those that are still working here, they are the true devotees of commitment and dedication. Hats off to all of you who are still in service. Though Bhagavan is not in our midst physically, this is the proof of your spiritual awareness. May Bhagavan be with you forever and ever. That's my fervent prayer. And two, Baba is known for his quality. As a university, we should be number one in this country, if possible, in the world. As a hospital, it should be number one. As a hospital in the number one, so that we'll never say no to any patient at any point of time. If any patient returns home for the attention that is not paid, understand, Baba is returning home. That Baba is going back. That I am disappointing my Swami. And while giving medicines, if I say I do not have, understand, Baba is frustrated. He is frustrated with us if we do not give enough of medicines. He will be disappointed if any patient goes home unattended for any reason. My friends, for all the grace that we have, for all the mercy that we received, for all the comforts and conveniences that we enjoy today, should we not keep the mission of Sai, the flag of Sai, fly high above all the contemporary world? It is our duty to keep up the tempo, the quality of the hospital. One more word. It is equally important to bring about health awareness. It's not enough if we just treat people and send them back. The awareness of health about which Swami speaks of. I know the weakness with Anil Kumar is he has a lot to speak and time being short. Just one or two hints. Health awareness. In what way our specialty, our hospital, different from other hospitals? Patients come, we treat and send them home. Is that all? I go to the college and teach. Is that all? Sai teacher is not merely a teacher. Sai teacher is a transmitter of Sai message to his students. And a doctor in a Sai institution is the one who brings this health consciousness, the health awareness. What do I mean by that? Swami tells number of people repeatedly, tell everybody they should have moderation in their food, moderation in their talk, moderation in their desires. Moderation, food, talk and desires will make you healthy, wealthy and wise. You don't need a doctor at all. This awareness has to be brought. And Baba says, we give so many tonics to patients. Yes, hemoglobin content is less. Okay, something wrong with the bones, have some calcium. We suggest certain vitamins and tonics. Baba wants us to give the tonic of contentment. The tonic of contentment is a part of awareness. Eagerness to serve. Eagerness to serve. How to impart joy to others is the multivitamin tablet. So multivitamin tablet of spreading joy and the tonic of contentment have got to be prescribed, and this sort of awareness has got to be brought in. As Baba says, why are we sick? Why are we sick? Why people are sick? One time, I know, old timers may be knowing, every second day during Dasara festival was observed as a hospital day in those years. All doctors come in a procession, Purnachandra auditorium. They all line up and stand. Swami will have a photograph with them. And the superintendent will read the list. So many patients treated, so many beds and all that. And what is Swami's speech? నాకు ఈ ఆసుపత్రి యందు ఎంతమంది రోగులకు చికిత్స చేసినారో, ఎంతమందికి ఔషధములు ఇచ్చినారో విచారం వేస్తుంది, కానీ సంతోషమే లేదు. ఇఫ్ యూ గివ్ ది నంబర్ ఆఫ్ పేషెంట్స్ ట్రీటెడ్ హియర్, ఇఫ్ యూ గివ్ ది నంబర్ ఆఫ్ మెడిసిన్స్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూట్ హియర్, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ఎట్ ఆల్ హ్యాపీ. ఒక్క పేషెంట్ కూడా ఉండనప్పుడు స్వామికి ఎంతో సంతోషం అవుతుంది. వెన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ వన్ పేషెంట్, స్వామి విల్ బి హ్యాపీ, మీనింగ్ ఆల్ ఆర్ హెల్దీ. Because no doctor would tell his patient, see you next time or see you soon. And no patient would say, I'll come again. We don't say that. All should be healthy. Attitude is important. Attitude of generosity. Let us be generous to everybody. This attitude. And fortitude, attitude and fortitude, the balance between pain and pleasure, happiness and sorrow, that fortitude is required. Enthusiasm to do good, enthusiasm to spread goodness among the people. And Bhagwan says this, the mental balance is required. The moment I shout at people, it is rajasic quality. The moment I'm dull, indifferent, I'm tamasic. If I'm pious and noble, respond and react to the situation and to the ambience, then I'm sattvic. That's what Bhagwan says. Further, Bhagwan tells all of us, friends, I'm not hiding a secret. Everyone did a great sacrifice to be here. These days when things are calculated in terms of coins, you have preferred to calculate in terms of grace and blessing, not coins. We have opted this kind of life. Take our students who are serving here in these hospitals. Students of such a university serving in all these hospitals. All of them are first-class students. All of them are gold medals. All of them are highly talented. They have dedicated their life to serving these institutions. We should love them. We should love them. We should help them. We should encourage them. Do everything possible to see that they continue to work among us. If any one student is frustrated, we are responsible. If any student leaves this institution, we are responsible, because we are not able to talk to him. We are not able to do that what he really expects of us. So let us treat everybody as brothers and sisters. That is very important thing. Change our vision. Today, after Swami left us physically, our vision cannot be as before. Our vision should be towards mission of Sai. Vision, what would happen after 10 years? How should we plan for 20 years? That should be vision, not for this day. This day is gone. Come on, tear off one sheet from the calendar. No. Let's work with a vision. Change your vision. That's important today. Let's also tell, as Baba wants us, a kind of awareness, that people should give up smoking, they should give up drinking, they should give up non-vegetarian food so that they'll be healthy, that we should spread. Let us release people out of tension. There are people that add to the tension. No. Let us see, they will be tension free. Just as when you go to Swami, when he stands in front of you, gone. No tension. Why? Yes, he is the only one who can make you tension free, stress free. Why? How? Bhagavan, you are there. It is your tension to make me free from my tension. It is your stress to make me non-stressful in my life. So let us do that. See that there nobody will be under tension. Why fear when I am here? Why fear when I am here? So let's know that, realize and believe that, so that there would not be any tension. Bhagavan also wants us to tell everybody not to eat too much of spicy food, though I have not been yet able to follow, and not to take too many cups of tea, which would also affect our health. And then a highlight of this is this: those that spend their lives in a spiritual organization like this, which has got nothing to do with money, will live long, healthy, religious, spiritual life. A guarantee given by Bhagavan. What more you want? What more you want? Therefore, my friends, we are specially privileged to work in this institution. Let the coming generations say, Dr. Acharya worked here, Mr. Pavan Kumar worked here, Dr. Narayan Murthy worked here, Dr. Kamakshi was here. Coming generations will speak of us, not our children. If you 10 lakhs, they will say, why not 20 lakhs? Because the other boy got 20 lakhs from his father. You are giving only 10. But Sai devotees will speak with gratitude, with love. They take you as role models. What made Dr. Acharya come all the way from Gulf? What made him to kick off that and stay with us? What made Dr. Mr. Pavan to be here, though he has got a brilliant career outside? What made all of you to come here, spare this time? Because time is money for you, I know. What made? Because Swami said, I take care of you. Your lives are going to be sublime. In human history, no man of wealth is ever remembered. No man of money is ever taken as a role model. A man of virtue, a man of integrity, a man of character, a man of prayer, a man of principles is remembered forever and ever. The future history, the future will record all your names for having rendered your services, and Bhagavan will feel proud of his children. My children are doing good in the general hospital. How he speaks of his institutions elsewhere, it is sight for gods. He won't appreciate you on your face, no, because he's a typical mother. Indian mind requires not to praise on their face. That's our Indian style. We praise in the absence. That's what Baba does. Ma aspetri chala goppakuntunnaya. Ma aspetri ekkadi nunchi vastu undaru, enta chestu undaru, em telusaya meeku, prapanchamlo ekkada undadu. What do you know about my hospitals? What kind of quality of doctors I have? What do you know after all? ఏమి ఇట్లా చేసేవారు ఉన్నారా? మా సేవాదారులు వాళ్ళు ఉన్నారు, ఎంత శుభ్రంగా ఉంచుతారు. మా డాక్టర్స్ ఉన్నారు, ఎంత త్యాగం చేసినారు. మా నర్సెస్ ఉన్నారు, ఎంత సేవాదృక్పథముగా ఉన్నది. ఇట్టి హాస్పిటల్ మీకు ఎక్కడైనా ఉండదా? హీ ఫీల్ సో ప్రౌడ్ ఆఫ్ అస్. ఓ లార్డ్, వీ షల్ నాట్ డిసప్పాయింట్ యూ. యాజ్ లాంగ్ వీ లివ్, వీ సర్వ్ యూ స్వామి. ద లైఫ్ ఈజ్ మెంట్ ఫర్ యూ. The life is dedicated to you. When once the river got united into the ocean, it will not come back. Swami, our loyalty to you, our devotion towards you, can never go back because you and I are one. You and I are one. Away I am none. With you I am one. Therefore, may that Sai inspire everybody. I thank you for having heard my talk in attention. You have taken more time. I beg your pardon. But I thought, being a member of the organization, it's worthwhile sharing my views on the Sai mission apart from healthcare. Thank you. May Bhagwan be with you. Continue to inspire you forever and ever in future. May Swami bless you and your families. Thank you very much. Oh, all of you. Shira Dhisayana Narayana Akshira. Shira Dhisayana Narayana. Lakshmi Ramana Narayana. Narayana Hari Narayana. Vaasa Narayana. Hare Vaidehi Mohana Narayana. Narayana Hari Narayana. Narayana Sai Narayana. Jana Paripala Narayana. Enata Jana Paripala Narayana. Shira Dhisayana Narayana. Shri Lakshmi Ramana Narayana. Hari Narayana Hari Narayana. Narayana Hari Narayana. Anar Hari Rupa Narayana. Vaikuntha Vasa Narayana. Vaidehi Mohana Narayana. Hari Hari Narayana Sai Narayana. Hari Hari Hey Narayana Hari Narayana. Hey Nata Jana Paripala Narayana. Hey Nata Jana Paripala Narayana. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.